There are new signs tonight that former Alaska Governor Sarah Palin may enter the race to take on the Anointed One in 2012. In an interview with Newsweek magazine, Palin said, quote, "I believe that I can win a national election." She went on to say, "I'm not so egotistical to believe that it has to be me or it can only be me to turn things around, but I do believe that I can win." But that's not the only clue. Over the weekend, she wrote a post on Facebook titled, "The Sugar Daddy has run out of sugar. Now we need new leaders." In the posting, Palin takes Obama to task over the debt ceiling debate and his failed fiscal policy, saying, quote, "We need real leaders who will put aside their own political self-interest to do what is right for the nation. And if they don't emerge, well, America has a do-over in November 2012. But was she referring to herself? For someone else joining me now are the vice president of the Young Americas Foundation, Kate Obenshain, and Fox News contributor, Kirsten Powers. Guys, good to see you. The second quote, Kate, I think she was referring to, because we're at a very crucial moment for the Republicans. They were elected here for one reason only, and that's to get spending under control, balance the budget without raising taxes. And a lot of people were worried they may cave. I think John Boehner went a long way and Eric Cantor to say, no, we're not going to raise taxes. We're going to hold the line. But how that, you know, ends up is anyone's guess at this point. But it seems like they're holding for now.
Right. Look, Sarah Palin is the undisputed head of the Tea Party, and she controls a lot of conservatives in terms of directing their opinions. And she has made it perfectly clear, if Boehner and the Republicans in Congress compromise on even raising the debt limit, even with the deal, basically, then she's not going to be happy. I think that's what she said. Palin has been attacking and calling Obama on what the realities are since the very beginning, when nobody else would challenge him. She's been doing it. So the Sugar Daddy article is not a big shock. But I think that the Newsweek article is really quite telling. First of all, that the mainstream media seems to be shifting its opinion a little bit, giving her a little bit more credibility. What a great cover that was for her, saying, I can win. But I think that there is going to be a shift right now with the Undefeated movie coming out by Bannon. And we're going to see over the next couple of months Palin's image undergo this sort of restoration, and it just remains to be seen whether she can pull it off.
You know, Kirsten, this is interesting to me because the media has so viciously attacked her, and at times you have said that they've gone way overboard.
Yep.
Let's say Governor Palin got in and won the nomination, okay, which I think she would play a very big part. She would be for cutting taxes. Obama would be for raising them. She would be for a stronger national defense. She would secure the border. She would want energy dependence. In other words, you'd have two very distinct, despite it, put the personalities aside, America would have a choice about the future of the country, and they'd also have to measure Obama's failed record. I think she'd win, and I think she'd win by margins that would give liberals like you fits at night.
What kind of margins are these exactly, Sean? I want a prediction.
Well over
here, 50, a hard prediction.
Well over 54-55%.
Interesting. Okay. Well, I mean, look, Obama is clearly very vulnerable because of the economy. So, you know, I would take issue with some of the other stuff in terms of a stronger national security. We have a very strong national security. It's, in fact, he's almost a distinguishable. I think you should be happy with his foreign policy, Sean, because it's just practically
he's made a few adjustments.
George Bush's. But look, I think Sarah Palin would be a strong candidate. I've always said that, and I think she's always been underestimated. And you know, I wouldn't read an article by Peter Boyer as being the mainstream media being supportive, because he's a true journalist. You know, somebody who I just have the most respect for, and I think
is
a very, very fair journalist. But I think she'll get a really hard time from the media, actually.
No, I think it'll be vicious, you know, on steroids. Kate, do you agree with me that Obama's incompetence is going to be a major part of this election? And the philosophical difference is, I think America wants to go on a new path. I think he'll lose.
Well, of course. And the unemployment numbers will be display number one. That will be what he's judged on, and his overall incompetence with the economy. But I think Kirsten is right that Palin will be a force to contend with. And she does have very high negatives within the Republican Party. But again, the next couple of months will be seen whether she can pull those down. But she has always surprised everyone. And when you look back to the McCain campaign, the one time that the campaign really took off was when she was announced to be the vice presidential candidate. It was only when the economy tanked that his number, and he took off, you know, he shut down his campaign.
Kirsten, I want to give you the last word. Go ahead.
Look, I think, like I said, I think she'll be a formidable candidate. I still don't think she would beat Obama, and certainly not by the margins that you're giving, but I think she would be a tough candidate.
Obama has failed the country and has put us on a track to disaster.
Just about any Republican is going to beat Obama if these numbers stay the same.
All right, guys, good to see you both.